It's wonderful to have you at the Media Skin Gifting Lounge today. You're looking forward to the event.
Yeah, I'm so excited to be here. I haven't been downstairs yet, but I know there's a lot of amazing brands, and I can't wait to test everything out and get some little goodie bags to take home.
There's a lot of great beauty products on offer today. I have to ask, what products do you swear by? What kind of products do you use?
Do you know, I try and stay as natural as possible. I'm not very high maintenance. I stick to what my mom taught me, oil of Olay. That's the best for me.
What do you think of the idea of a gifting lounge? I mean, it's very big in the States, but we're just sort of starting to get them over here. Do you think it's going to catch on? Do you think we're going to get more of them?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I've been to a few before. In this precise venue, actually, it was beauty bloggers. I think it's a great idea. They have them at the Oscars, don't they? Gifting suites and gifting lounges. I think it's a great way to promote new products and anything that is new and trying to lift off the ground. So I think it's great.
Talking about yourself, what's coming up next for you? After you've picked up all your free stuff today, what are you going off to do next?
I'll be heading off to the gym. No, I'm in the process of writing my first book, as well as working on a couple of shoots that I've got coming up. So I've just got to stay focused on my training and just work hard on everything that's coming up.
Curious, the book, is that fiction? Is it fact? I mean, can you tell us anything about that?
It's fact, and it's about the industry, and that's all I can say.
I guess, obviously you can't spill any details of the book, but what made you want to write a book about the industry?
Well, I've been in the modelling industry and for quite a while now, and I've had a taste of presenting and acting, and I know a lot of people that are in the public eye, and it's not all it seems to be, so that's what the book is based around.
I mean, particularly, modelling is something that I guess provokes a lot of debate. You know, people talk about the responsibility that I guess the industry has towards promoting healthy and realistic body image, particularly for women. How well do you think that issue is being addressed by the industry?
I don't think it's been addressed as much as it needs to be. There's still a lot of size zero models. There's still a lot of top supermodels that are promoting a very slim, very slender size. I personally am not a size zero. I don't believe in it. I believe a woman should have curves and embrace being somewhat more natural than, to me, someone being a size zero is not natural, unless that's your natural build. But to not go days without eating or just drinking water just to obtain a certain size, I just don't think it's right.
Would you say there are any positive role models looking at the industry? Would you say there are any particular models that are actually flying the flag for healthy body image?
I think Kate Upton is absolutely beautiful. She's not size zero, and she just seems very curvy, and she's natural. I definitely think she's a great, great role model.
Clearly, the industry has to maybe change and take more responsibility, like you say. How do you think that can happen? What changes would you like to see?
I'd like to see maybe top-end designers using more natural size models, maybe like an 8 to 10 rather than a size 0. The people that they use in the magazines, maybe not so much airbrushing needs to be done. Something that's obtainable and something that young girls can look up to and think, do you know what, I can achieve that. So just little things like that.
I mean, in terms of airbrushing, again, I mean, that's another sort of big debate. Do you think that particularly when it comes to education for young people, they need to be made actively aware of just how artificial the images that we see on billboards, magazines and on screen actually are?
Yes, 100%. I think a lot of the young girls in this day and age have a preconceived idea of what is the standard and all what's acceptable of what they should be like. There's girls as young as 10, 11 years old aspiring to be someone like, for instance, Kim Kardashian, who has millions behind her, who has a whole team behind her. I think they need to be made aware from a young age, perhaps in schools, parents and so forth, that it's not natural to be that perfect. And who knows, maybe they need to create something in computer class where they can show them what can be done.
So we have seen some celebrities, like, I mean, Britney Spears very famously actively released images of herself that weren't airbrushed to kind of show the difference. Do you think that's the kind of change that, particularly when it comes to famous faces, the kind of the example that they can help set?
I mean, that's definitely one way that it could be done. We've got Alicia Dixon who did the same over here, and it really opens your eyes as to how much an image can be changed. So I definitely think a lot more of that needs to be done. But then on the other hand, you're trying to sell a magazine. If you're trying to portray an image of fashion and makeup and beauty and health, I mean, maybe a little help is okay. I mean, gosh, I know my images get touched up all the time.
Hopefully not too much, I'm sure. I guess my final question, for a lot of young, particularly girls watching this, they see modeling as something they'd like to aspire to. It's a career they'd like to have. Honestly, would you recommend it to young women? Do you think it's something that they should be aiming for in life? Or, I mean, what are the pros and cons, I guess, of entering the industry?
One thing I know for sure is that it's a very, very difficult industry to get into. Every single second person is trying to break into it. You're going to get a lot of doors shut in your face, and it really messes with your mind, it can do, and what you perceive as a good body image. So my advice to anyone would be, if you're 100% comfortable and confident within yourself and know who you are as a person, then by all means go ahead. But if you're not, then I wouldn't advise it.